In the video called Defining Your Objectives, we talked about breaking down a topic into its component ideas as a first step towards writing learning objectives. I asked a group of expert teaching assistants in science and engineering to do this exercise with a topic that they've taught. Joining the group is Sarah Sider, a science teaching fellow in the Ecology and Evolutionary Biology Department, who has done this with numerous faculty. Here's their discussion.
I'm a material scientist, and my topic, you know, very introductory topic is crystal structures and materials. There's a lot that goes into that topic. You could spend semesters on crystal structures. But from a, I guess, basic material standpoint, it's important to realize that atoms and materials are arranged in a particular structure that's sort of a long-range repeating structure. And a lot of the properties that we see on a macro scale from metals and their behavior in all of the applications we use them in stem from how the atoms are arranged in that particular structure. So if they don't understand what those structures are, then they can't really extrapolate out and, you know, sort of predict what's going to happen on a larger scale.
Mm-hmm. So would the sort of like properties of the different crystal structures then be a separate learning goal? Is that something you'd have like multiple learning goals for?
Yeah, so where they're applied would be multiple other learning goals. But it's hard enough to just understand what they are and what makes them different, you know?
Right. So that makes sense. I think that's a really good point that you're like starting, like for any given topic, you could have lots of learning goals that you might need to accomplish in order to successfully implement that or successfully get your students to understand that topic.
Mm-hmm. Great. Someone else?
I went with plate tectonics, which is one of basically kind of the most fundamental topic in introductory geology is because it relates to everything else.
Can you just sort of tease that out?
Understanding what drives it. So what drives the actual process of plate tectonics, and then what happens, what do we see on the surface because of plate tectonics occurring? Because, you know, it's kind of cause and effect sort of things. And then how plate tectonics can be related to many other different processes on Earth, because a lot of introductory students don't realize it, but, you know, plate tectonics, which is just the movement of Earth's crust and the different pieces of it, actually has a huge, huge impact on things like climate and ocean currents and that kind of stuff. So it ties into everything else, too.
So one from this side of the table.
Yeah. So I chose the topic of structures analysis that could be related to civil engineering or as well like architectures or architectural engineering, and this is pretty much as well like an introductory course. And the main goal will be understand how different type of loads and forces that applies to different structures and buildings and how these buildings or structures behave into each of these loads. The ultimate goal is computing, okay, how much concrete do you need to put or how much this needs to resist in order to support all these people walking around. So before that, you need to understand why you care about this and why it's important that you know what is the effect of all these loads into your building.
And what goes into understanding those loads? It seems like there would be some physics, there would be some like tension and strain.
Yeah. So of course you need a little bit of physics background, like you were saying, Newton laws and things like that. So knowing that when there you have a force, maybe this will get like some acceleration and some deformation. Mm-hmm. So for sure, like a little bit background.
Okay, Chelsea.
So ITA for a class in animal behavior, and the very first like lecture is a lesson on Tinbergen's four questions. So these are four questions by which you can explore animal behavior. So it's really important for students to know these because like the whole course is essentially based off of these questions and how students will be approaching different behavioral problems throughout the semester. So it's just important to know the questions, so just be able to like write out a sentence of what each of the questions is exploring, but then of course to apply these questions, like if you saw this behavior, how could you explore it from this question versus that question, kind of thing. So
yeah, no, I really like this as a learning goal a lot, because I can kind of see two learning goals, like you've already identified that, like what are the four questions is sort of like a lower Bloom's level of like recall and then apply. And I really like it because it allows you to, you can even get up into sort of the compare and contrast, because you're like, is this evolutionary developmental causation a better fit for this particular scenario? So
absolutely.
I feel like there's lots of good things to work with.